Our today's topic is again how people participated in civil disobedience movement. Yesterday you have done role of peasants. Then you have read about industrialist, high caste and low caste Hindus. Now next is women. All of you know it very well that women were the active participants of this movement. Sarojini Naidu was one of the women member who joined this movement from the very beginning. So role of women, women were the active participants of this movement. And Sarojini Naidu was one of the women member who joined this movement from the very beginning. And you know it very well on the way where Gandhiji, during this movement where Gandhiji stopped and took rest, women from their houses came to listen to the speeches of Mahatma Gandhi with their kids, and women were so impressed that they walked with Mahatma Gandhi. You will write same here, that women were the active participants of this movement. Sarojini Naidu was one of the women member who joined this movement from the very beginning. And during the civil disobedience movement, during Dandi March, you can also write like this, during Dandi March, wherever Gandhiji stopped on the way to deliver speeches, women with their kids came out of their houses to listen to the speeches of Mahatma Gandhi. And women were so impressed that they walked with Mahatma Gandhi in this movement. And women played important role in breaking down the laws made by British. And after that, when Gandhiji said that women are not fit for politics, they had to do only household work. No important position was given to women in the Congress, as Sarojini Naidu was one of the women members who joined the march from the very beginning. But no important position was given to the women in the Congress. Gandhiji himself was on the view that women are not fit for politics. They had to do only household work. So this is about women. Women active participants thi, badh chadh ke part liya. Sarojini Naidu was one of the women members, joined this march from the very beginning. And during this march, wherever Gandhiji stopped to deliver speeches, and women with their kids came out to listen to the speeches of Mahatma Gandhi. Women were so impressed that they walked with Mahatma Gandhi. Earlier, the number of members, which was only 78, when Gandhiji started this Dandi March, and now the number reached to 2 lakh. The women joined this movement wholeheartedly. Women also participated in breaking down the laws made by the British, but they were not given any important position in the Congress. And Gandhiji himself was on the view that women are not fit for politics. They had to do only household work. So this is about the role of women in civil disobedience movement. Next is Muslims. As you know it very well, during non-cooperation movement, feelings of alienation came among Muslims. And in this movement, they didn't came. They didn't join this movement. Muslims didn't join the civil disobedience movement. And Muslims were also on the view that Congress was the committee of Hindus, and it was dominated by Hindu Mahasabha, and it would not do anything from the Muslims. During the non-cooperation movement, feelings of alienation came among Muslims because Gandhi ji ne wo movement withdraw karte waqt Ali brother se consult nahi kiya tha. So movement, Muslims didn't join the civil disobedience movement. And on the other hand, you can also write, Muslims were on the view that Congress was the committee of Hindus, Hindu's ki committee, and it would not bother about the Muslims. It would do nothing about the Muslims. Muslims also formed Muslim League in 1906. Mein unhone apni ek, jaise Congress ki thi na, Hindu Mahasabha. मुस्लिम्स ने बनाई थी मुस्लिम लीग. कांग्रेस की थी ये मुस्लिम्स की है, नाम से क्लियर है. कांग्रेस की थी हिंदू महासभा, हिंदू महासभा. कमेटी ऑफ हिंदू, ये मुस्लिम्स की थी, ये हिंदुओं की थी. अब ध्यान से सुनो. और मुस्लिम्स पार्टिसिपेटेड ड्यूरिंग नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट. फीलिंग्स ऑफ एलिनेशन केम अमंग द मुस्लिम्स. दे वर ऑल्सो ऑन द व्यू दैट कांग्रेस कांग्रेस वॉज द कमेटी ऑफ हिंदूज एंड इट वॉज डोमिनेटेड बाई हिंदू महासभा एंड इट वुड डू नथिंग फॉर द मुस्लिम्स. दे ऑल्सो फॉर्म्ड मुस्लिम लीग इन 1906. ये आना नहीं है बिकॉज इट्स नॉट गिवन इन द बुक, बट आपको पता होना चाहिए 1906 में इन्होंने क्या बनाई थी, मुस्लिम लीग. फ्रॉम द मुस्लिम्स मोहम्मद अली जीना, ही वॉज द लीडर ऑफ मुस्लिम लीग देन. फ्रॉम द मुस्लिम्स मोहम्मद अली जीना, ही वॉज द लीडर ऑफ मुस्लिम लीग. ही वॉज नॉट द फाउंडर ऑफ मुस्लिम लीग, ही वॉज द लीडर ऑफ मुस्लिम लीग एट दैट टाइम. फ्रॉम द मुस्लिम्स मोहम्मद अली जीना, ही वॉज द लीडर ऑफ मुस्लिम लीग इन दोज डेज. ही डिमांडेड सेपरेट इलेक्टोरेट फॉर मुस्लिम्स. ही ऑल्सो सेड that he would give up his demand of separate electorate if their seats would be reserved in the areas where Muslims were in majority, such as in Punjab, such as in Bengal. He said that he would give up his demand of separate electorate if their seats would be reserved in areas where Muslims were in majority. As the negotiation was going on, one of the leader of Hindu Mahasabha, as the negotiation was going on, abhi baat chit chal rahi thi, one of the leader of Hindu Mahasabha, M.R. Jaikar, as the negotiation was going on, one of the leader of Hindu Mahasabha, M.R. Jaikar, said that they would not do any kind of compromise with Muslims. Muhammad Ali Jinnah demanded separate electorate for Muslims. He also said that he would give up his demand if seats were reserved for Muslims in the areas where they were in majority. As the negotiation was going on, one of the leader of the Hindu Mahasabha, M.R. Jaikar, he said that they would not do any kind of compromise with Muslims. So that's why Jinnah demanded separate state for Muslims. Now he demanded separate state. He refused to live with Hindus. He refused to live in the same state. He demanded separate state for the Muslims. And due to this, India was, and on the other hand, you can also write the British also followed the policy of divide and rule. They also wanted to divide Hindus and Muslims. So India was divided into two parts, India and Pakistan, in 1947. So dream of Gandhiji was shattered because he wanted united India, not divided India. Gandhiji was shocked because he wanted united India, not divided India. So this is the about the whole chapter we have done. मुस्लिम्स पार्टिसिपेटेड. मुस्लिम्स तो आए नहीं इस मूवमेंट में, क्यों नहीं आए? फीलिंग्स ऑफ एलिनेशन डेवलप हो चुकी थी. कब? ड्यूरिंग द नॉन कॉपरेशन मूवमेंट से ही चली आ रही थी. एंड ऑन द अदर हैंड मुस्लिम्स वर आल्सो ऑन द व्यू दैट कांग्रेस इज द कमेटी ऑफ हिंदूज एंड डोमिनेटेड बाय हिंदू महासभा एंड वुड डू नथिंग फॉर मुस्लिम्स. एंड मुस्लिम्स आल्सो फॉर्म मुस्लिम लीग. इन दोज डेज द लीडर ऑफ मुस्लिम लीग वाज मोहम्मद अली जीना. ही डिमांडेड सेपरेट इलेक्टोरेट फॉर द मुस्लिम्स. ही सेड, साथ में उसने और अपना आइडिया भी दिया कि ही वुड गिव अप हिज डिमांड ऑफ सेपरेट इलेक्टोरेट इफ सीट्स वर रिजर्व फॉर मुस्लिम्स इन द एरियाज वेयर दे वर इन मैजॉरिटी. बट एज द नेगोशिएशन वॉज गोइंग ऑन, एम आर जयकर लीडर ऑफ हिंदू महासभा रिफ्यूज टू डू एनी काइंड ऑफ कॉम्प्रोमाइज विद मुस्लिम्स. एंड ड्यू टू दिस जीना डिमांडेड सेपरेट स्टेट फॉर मुस्लिम्स. एंड Gandhiji was shocked because he wanted united India, not divided India. Next is, so how people participated in this movement? Agar ye paper mein question aaya, women participated, how Muslims participated? What do you know about Pune Pact? Ya role of high caste? What do you know about the participation of high caste and low caste Hindus? Peasants, industrialist peasants, I told you have to divide in two parts, rich peasants, poor peasants, industrialists and workers. So in this way you can write this, these questions. Okay, next is sense of collective belongingness. Sense of collective belongingness. In this you will write first, united struggles. United struggles. अब इसमें आप बता दोगे Indians joined their hands with each other, though they were Muslims, though they were Hindus, Sikhs, or from any other different community against British. People joined their hands with each other, क्योंकि जब division पहले तो आपको पता ही है British, Hindu and Muslims ने इकट्ठे सब कुछ किया, एक British के against movements launch की. So they people joined their hands with each other against the British. First of all, you will write united struggle. United struggle में आप बताओगे people, though they were from different communities, Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, they all joined their hands against the British. They wanted to get freedom from British rule. So first point you will write like this, united struggle. Next, आप points बनाते जाओ इसमें. First is united struggle. United struggle में आप बता दो कैसे लोगों ने मिलके part लिया. And second, you will write united struggle. In this, you will write, in this united struggles में आप लिखोगे Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs, they all joined their hands against the British because they all wanted to get freedom from British rule. ठीक. Next, आप बता दोगे images of Bharat Mata. Images of Bharat Mata. Images of Bharat Mata. अब इसमें आप बताओगे first image of Bharat Mata was, first image of Bharat Mata was made by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. First image of Bharat Mata was made by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. First image of Bharat Mata was prepared by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Write down the name. Who prepared the first image of Bharat Mata? Bankim. One mark question. Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay is also popularly known as Bankim Chandra Chatterjee. Bankim Chandra Chatterjee भी कहते हैं. तो आपको Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay भी लिखना है, ठीक है? Bankim Chandra Chatterjee भी इसको popularly बोलते हैं. तो first image of Bharat Mata was prepared by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. And Abhinandan Nath Tagore also prepared the image of Bharat Mata. Later Abhinandan Nath Tagore also prepared the names are given in the book, you can write from there. Later Abhinandan Nath Tagore also prepared the image of Bharat Mata. Many artists, painters prepared the images of Bharat Mata. Prepared the images of Bharat Mata. And this created the feeling of motherland among the people of India. And this created the feeling of love for the motherland. This created the feeling of love for the motherland among the people of India. First image of Bharat Mata was prepared by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Then Abhinandan Nath Tagore also prepared the image of Bharat Mata. Later, various artists, painters prepared the images of Bharat Mata. Abhinandan Nath Tagore showed Bharat Mata divine and calm. Divine and calm दिखाया उसने Bharat Mata को. And these images created the feelings of love for the motherland country among Indians. For the motherland country among Indians. Next, you will write icons. Next heading अपन आ दोगे icons and symbols. Icons and symbols. Icons and symbols. अब इसमें आप बताओगे icons and symbols में Swaraj flag was designed by Mahatma Gandhi in 1921. Swaraj flag was designed by Mahatma Gandhi in 1921. Swaraj flag, who designed Swaraj flag? One more question. Mahatma Gandhi in 1921. It had red, green and white color. Swaraj flag किसने डिजाइन किया? Swaraj tricolor flag was designed by Mahatma Gandhi in 1921 having red, green and white color. It had spinning wheel in the center and this spinning wheel represented the idea of self-help. It had spinning wheel in the center and this spinning wheel represented the idea of self-help. Swadeshi flag was also designed during the Swadeshi movement. It was not designed by Mahatma Gandhi. Swadeshi flag was also made during the Swadeshi movement having red, green and yellow color. Ab yahan pe white ki jagah yellow. Swadeshi flag was also designed during Swadeshi movement having red, green and yellow color. It had eight lotuses representing the eight provinces. It had how many lotuses? Eight lotuses representing eight provinces of British, representing the eight provinces of British. And it had crescent moon also, which represented Hindu Muslim unity. Listen again, Swaraj flag was designed by Mahatma Gandhi in 1921 having red, green and white color. It had spinning wheel in the center, represented the idea of self-help. Swadeshi flag was also designed during Swadeshi movement having red, green and yellow color. It had eight lotuses representing eight provinces of British, and it had crescent moon representing Hindu Muslim unity. Carrying national flag during marches over the movements spread the feelings of nationalism among the Indians. Carrying flag during the marches or movements spread the feelings of nationalism among Indians. Next, National song and national anthem. National song of our country is Vande Mataram. नेशनल सॉन्ग ऑफ अवर कंट्री इज, विच इज द नेशनल सॉन्ग ऑफ अवर कंट्री, वंदे मातरम, एंड इट वॉज रिटन बाय बंकिम सेम, इट वॉज रिटन बाय बंकिम चंद्र चट्टोपाध्याय, इट वॉज रिटन बाय बंकिम चंद्र चट्टोपाध्याय इन 1870. It was written by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay in 1870. National Song of India is Vande Mataram. It was written by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay in 1870. Later he added this song in his novel Anandamath. Later he added this song in his novel Anandamath. So one more question: who wrote Anandamath? Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Who wrote Vande Mataram? Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Who prepared the first आप कह सकते हो इमेज ऑफ भारत माता? बंकिम चंद्र चट्टोपाध्याय. तो सबका आंसर यही है, ठीक है. ही एडेड हिज सॉन्ग, विच सॉन्ग? वंदे मातरम, इन हिज नॉवल अनंतमठ. एंड दिस सॉन्ग वॉज संग ड्यूरिंग स्वदेशी मूवमेंट. ये सॉन्ग कब गाया गया? ड्यूरिंग स्वदेशी मूवमेंट, एंड स्प्रेड द फीलिंग्स ऑफ नेशनलिज्म अमंग इंडियंस. नेशनल एंथम वॉज ऑल्सो रिटन बाय रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर. National anthem of our country, Jan Gan Man, was also written by Rabindranath Tagore. National anthem of our country, Jan Gan Man, was also written by Rabindranath Tagore in those days, and it spread the feelings of nationalism among Indians. National song, national anthem, दोनों ने ही लोगों के मनों में कैसी feeling spread की? Nationalism. Is it clear? Who wrote Vande Mataram? Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Who wrote Anandamath? Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Who prepared the first image of Bharat Mata? Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay. Is it clear? Who wrote National Anthem of India, Jan Gan Man? Rabindranath Tagore. So all these spread the feeling. National song, national anthem spread the feelings of nationalism among Indians. Is it clear? Next. In this you will write Rabindranath Tagore collected folk tales, fairy tales in Bengal. Rabindranath Tagore collected folk tales, fairy tales in Bengal and in South India. In South India, Natesha Shastri, Pandit Natesha Shastri, and in South India, Pandit Natesha Shastri collected folklores and published the folklore of Southern India. In South, Pandit Natesha Shastri collected folk tales, fairy tales, and collected folklores of Southern India. All this spread the feelings of nationalism among Indians. Last point is reinterpretation of history. Reinterpretation. Learn the spelling of history. Reinterpretation of history. In this in this you will write, by the end of 19th century, Indians started to have pride in the nation, started to feel pride in the nation. By the end of 19th century, Indians started feeling to have pride in the nation. They looking in the past. That's why they begin looking into the past to discover India's great achievement. For example, under India was golden period. Medicines. They encouraged Indians to have pride on the past and not to follow Western culture. अब उन्होंने क्या किया? Working, they started looking in the past to discover India's great achievements. They begin looking into the past to discover India's great achievement. They looking into the past to discover India's great achievements. अब किसकी क्या किया उन्होंने? What was the idea given by them? That under Guptas, India was known as golden period. Under Guptas, there was golden period in India. India mein golden period tha Guptas ke under. India had made great achievements in the field of science, mathematics, medicines. They encouraged Indians to have pride on the past and not to follow Western culture. So this is about reinterpretation of history. Logon ko samajh aa chuki thi. They begin looking into the past because they were on the view that past of India was very great. Under Guptas, it was known as golden sparrow. India ka golden period hai, Guptas ka period. Under Guptas, it had golden period. It had made great achievements in the fields of. Aap kaise bhi karke itna bada aapko nahi likhna, aap simple likho. The idea of history was reinterpreted. Isme aap batao ke Indians began looking into the past and they were on the view that India had great past. India had made great progress in the different fields such as in science, mathematics, medicines. They encouraged Indians to have pride in the past. So historians reinterpreted history. So in this way you can write सेंस ऑफ कलेक्टिव बिलोंगिंगनेस, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यूनाइटेड स्ट्रगल्स, आप अपने वे से लिख सकते हो कि सबने मिलके पार्ट लिया. इमेजेस ऑफ भारत माता, यू शुड नो द नेम हु क्रिएटेड द फर्स्ट इमेज ऑफ भारत माता, ठीक है, एंड लेटर हु प्रिपेयर्ड द इमेज ऑफ भारत माता, हु शोड भारत माता काम एंड डिवाइन, अभिनंदन नाथ टैगोर. नेक्स्ट, वेरियस आर्टिस्ट ऑल्सो पेंटर्स प्रिपेयर द इमेजेस ऑफ भारत माता, एंड ऑल दिस स्प्रेड, ऑल दिस क्रिएटेड द लव फॉर मदरलैंड कंट्री अमंग इंडियंस, ठीक है. नेक्स्ट, यू विल राइट अबाउट आइकन्स एंड सिंबल्स. इसमें आप बता सकते हो कि स्वराज फ्लैग बना, स्वदेशी फ्लैग बना, किसने बनाया स्वराज फ्लैग, महात्मा गांधी 1921. कलर्स पता होने चाहिए, पेपर में आता होता है स्वदेशी फ्लैग के बारे में बताओ, स्वदेशी फ्लैग में कितने लोटसेस हैं, 8 लोटसेस. क्या रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं, 8 प्रोविंसेस ऑफ ब्रिटिश. फिर आपको बताना है कि उसमें क्रेसेंट मून भी है, रिप्रेजेंटिंग हिंदू मुस्लिम यूनिटी. नेक्स्ट इज कलर्स, आपको पता होने चाहिए दोनों फ्लैग्स के. गांधी जी के फ्लैग में सिर्फ व्हाइट कलर है, दूसरे में आपने येल्लो कर देना है. रेड ग्रीन सेम है, गांधी जी के फ्लैग का व्हाइट है, उधर येल्लो है. नेक्स्ट इज फोकलोर. इसमें आप बताओगे रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर कलेक्टेड फोक टेल्स, फेरी टेल्स इन बंगाल एंड इन साउथ. दिस वर्क वॉज डन बाई नतीशा शास्त्री एंड ही पब्लिश फोकलोर ऑफ सदरन इंडिया. वन मार्क क्वेश्चन, हु पब्लिश फोकलोर ऑफ सदरन इंडिया, नतीशा शास्त्री. टाइम ज़्यादा ही ओवर ही हो गया बच्चे. ओके, थैंक यू फॉर द लिसनिंग.